Every day is a good day to build a model kit. And today's an especially good day because I get to build up these Tom Daniel retro awesomeness in two boxes, two kits, one video, the Unreal Roller and the Groovy Grader. These are sent over by modelroundup.com. They are available right now, so you can buy these at this exact moment. You can pause the video, place your order, and watch me build them and anticipate yours arriving in the mail. First up, we are going to build the Groovy Grader. Check out all the cool features on that beauty. It's got a 454 rat motor, Groovy Grader logos, construction company. It's got a blade, dual wheels, wheelie bar, huge V8 hanging off the back. Let's take a look at all the parts that'll be in the box when you get yours. First up, fresh off the tree, literally the rubber tree, are the front wheels. And these are a squishy, feel like real rubber to me. Solid tire. They're nice and glossy and smooth. I'm going to fix that. We got the giant slicks in the back. He's got four of them all the way across the back. These are no-name tires to save money on branding. Smooth wall. Squishy, squishy, squishy. So these are pretty cool looking. You can also use these to hold your napkins at the dinner table. You just roll them up and stick them in there. You can have all fancy rubber napkin holders. We got a nice set of Atlantis decals, reproducing that blue and red Groovy Grader theme. Now, Atlantis decals have been pretty awesome every single time I've used them, and I say it every video. I expect a lot from them now. They're always very, very thin and lay into every groove, and I haven't torn one of them yet to date. We got a nice big chrome tree. On that chrome tree, two parts you don't see because they were loose in the bag, so watch out. We got our timing cover and our blower. We got wheelie bars here. We've got what looks like the belly that steers the axle or the front wheels. We've got our nice looking custom wheels on here. We got that belly blade, blower parts, valve covers, all kinds of sweet stuff going on there. You can see that it was molded in yellow, and then they clamp onto these little bars and dip it and get that or electroplate it. Maybe they don't dip these anymore. We got our steering intake system, big headers, which are all one piece. I love that. I hate when they're eight individual pieces. Those will be easy to work on. Let's switch to the other side of the table. There's not a billion parts in these kits. We got our backbone to the chassis here, molded in a nice yellow plastic. You wouldn't need a drop of paint. Just the model as it is, and the decals would get you a very, very nice looking Groovy Grader. I'm going a completely different way with mine, so stay tuned to see what I'm gonna do with it. We got that nice body, and that's a super gloss on there. We got that big engine hanging off the back. We got the nice seat, all the little vent holes in there. And the final tree, we've got wheel backs, we've got a roof to the grader, we've got cylinder heads, we've got what looks like the steering body for the blade. Looks like the blade will be movable. And are these for the rear axles? Probably, so that they can move up and down and articulate. We're going to find out. That is all the parts that's in the Groovy Grader. I'm going to get to building mine and be right back. Since I'm going to be painting my Groovy Grader and doing some cool stuff with it, I didn't go extremely far in the assembly. And what's nice is the tolerances in this kit allow me to do a lot of assembly after painting. And the way they're assembled, I won't end up with glue ruining everything. We've got the entire chrome tree here. All I've really done on that is assemble the blower scoop by gluing it with super glue very carefully. You really can't see the seam. And that'll look just fine when we're done. And I've glued the axle together. There's a two-piece axle there, super glue on that one as well. The rest of the chrome tree needs my weathering treatment, and that I will show you how to do in the painting section. The engine is together, at least as far as I want to assemble it. I did put the chrome timing cover and the oil pan on. I want to paint that up, then I will paint the transmission here, get that done. I did attach the magneto on the back. It is canted a little forward because I want it to look a little beat up, and that is set that way. So that's all model glue and super glue together off the chrome tree. I remove the belt assembly. I want to paint that. I don't want a chrome belt. So that I will be painting. I did assemble the blower assembly. I do want to re-chrome that with paint instead of model chrome so that it looks different. So I've got that ready to go there. The beautiful chassis, that is a very elegant design, is all assembled. Now I did only go this far. I did not attach the roof. I didn't attach anything else because I want to get this painted and then start my weathering process. I want to be able to get in here and paint the seat. I want to paint the four black boots around the levers on the bottom. And I want to be able to, you can barely make them out, there you go, with the reflection, the gauges. I want to be able to get in there, so I didn't attach any of the rods or the roof or anything that I can attach later. You can see from underneath where our axles will attach, our belly blade, our front axle, and everything on there. Nice large pre-drilled and cast holes for the steering, the headlights, all the assemblies. And then this large tree here, of which I've only assembled the lights onto the roof, I've glued those on with model glue. Now I can just go ahead, paint the wheels, paint everything up, begin my weathering over in the paint booth. While that's drying, I'm going to start assembling the Unreal Roller. So as soon as we're done with the painting process of the Unreal Roller, I'll be back with a sub-assembly show-off of the Unreal Roller. Up next is the Unreal Roller, 1/24th scale, far out earth flattening machine. Pretty awesome. This thing has very much a steampunk look to it. Lots of chrome. We got rivets going along the body. We got these cool lantern style lights. It really is saying a steampunk thing to me. Let's take a look inside the box. Of course, it is an original Tom Daniel design. And if I'm not incorrect, his son is doing the new box art for all of these for Atlantis. This was sent over by modelroundup.com. It is available right now. First up, we'll take a look at the decal sheet. We got that nice orangish red with, it looks like, real metallic details. Look at that. Change as you go through. Beautiful. Body top, gas tank. Oh, and the sides look lovely. This one I'm going to take in a different direction than the Groovy grader. Here we've got those front rollers. Now they are loose on there. You'll notice a little scuffing on the chrome that's really unavoidable in modern packaging, but there's a way to fix that up quite a bit. We'll talk about that later in the video. We got the corrugated metal roof. You know the B-52 song, tin roof, rusted. Look at this actuation lever. Up on the side with the gears, we got the big, ooh, that would be handy for some of you custom model builders. The big footprint gas pedal. We got our headers hanging off the side. We got a belt drive. We got the engine there. We got our lantern. We got our fuel tank. We got our wheels for either side of those big chrome wheels in the front. Handling that one delicately because parts are falling off. Check out the steamroller wheels in the back. Not any tires in this kit. Remember, it's a steamroller. They can't put steam through rubber tires. Those are a different kind of roller. Got what looks like a step plate in the back, diamond plate, wheelie bars. Look at a farmer's seat, another steampunk theme. Got those cool lanterns. Yeah, so looking at some awesome stuff on here. Mirror finish on that chrome, gorgeous wheels. And check this out on the other side of the table. We're gonna show off the styrene now. It is molded in a sweet green metallic. That is gorgeous. All this inlay is where that big decal will go, or you could mask that off and paint it something nice. I don't think I'm gonna use any paint on this at all. This is gorgeous as it is with all that chrome. I think the way I'm gonna take this one is building it just as it is, right out of the box. Probably paint the engine, decorate that up. But this is a beautiful, beautiful plastic. I really like that. Way to go, Atlantis. There's your blower scoop even, molded in those colors. Check out the firebox. Definitely steam now. Firebox, steampunk. Got our gauges. We'll have to hand paint those. Got our engine block. Got the roof support. Wheelbacks, giant steering wheel. Axle. All kinds of cool stuff. And that's all the parts that are in the Unreal Roller. Very easy. I'm going to get to working on mine and I'll be back with this one too. The Unreal Roller is mostly assembled because I want to leave the beautiful chrome. I want to do this one brand shiny new, funky, funky new. So I haven't done a lot with it except assemble and it goes together crazy easy. Here is the blower scoop in the green with the seam. You can barely tell it's there. And I can barely tell. It's all the way along the bottom. That doesn't need anything except model glue run along the inside. And then we're set to go with that. So that's ready to go. We're just going to clear coat that. The blower housing is definitely going to get painted. So I will be painting that one. The engine will be painted. The blower, the engine, and the belt are going to get painted with the exact same engine color, blower color, and belt colors I used on the Groovy grader from that painting session. So that's all we're going to need there. We won't need a separate painting session on the Unreal Roller. These parts here, the steering wheel, the seat post, and the roll cage bar. The roll cage bar is going to get painted in the same chrome as the blower. So will the seat post. Once I prime them black, the steering wheel itself will get sprayed with the metallic for the center, and then I'm going to wood grain the outside by hand. So maybe I'll show that on film. The rest of the stuff has just been assembled. This is the awesome light assembly for the front of the roof assembly. Those are two pieces of chrome gently super glued together, and any cloudiness from the super glue will be removed once we apply future floor polish. Same with the moon tank. That will be removed. That will come off easily if there's any issues, but the seams are nice and thin. No problems with that if you take your time. The rest of the chrome is exactly as it is. I'll be tinting the tips of the pipes, but otherwise, black washing, stuff like that, I like it as it is, and I'm going to leave it because we'll be dressing it up with these sweet decals. So that's it. I'm just going to get these little parts here into the paint area. The rest of the Unreal Roller is a beautiful machine. You can see that it still turns. Now, I did glue the rear wheels in place. I don't want it to roll anywhere off the bench. I've got that diamond plate glued in the back. I've got the gauges and the doors. We'll black wash around those to accent them. I will do the gauges up, and then we will start attaching the other parts. I've got the wheelie bars on and all that. So it is a very nice looking assembly. I like the green behind the wheels, so I'm leaving it. Otherwise, I could have painted that black, but I am going to leave it. If I change my mind, those holes are so big, I can reach back in there with some black craft paint and paint those up. But as is, it's very nice looking, and I like it. The seam on the front roller is right there. Just position it underneath that arm, the support arm. Put it on your display shelf. Move that seam right there. You're never going to see it again. And you can still turn that wheel. You'll never see the seam. Not a problem. Stuff's really easy to work with. I'm going to be painting by hand when we get back. Thank you. The fun never ever stops. We've got the Unreal Roller and the Groovy Grader built by Atlant, or made by Atlantis, built by moi, yours personally, sent over by modelroundup.com. These kits are out and available right now. There is no waiting for them. These are on the website. I will link to both of them at modelroundup.com. We thank Kirk and Jack for sending these over. Two great guys that work there that I deal with all the time. Really sweet personalities. Real fun to work with. They've been sponsoring the show for a few years now, and they always send over the most fun stuff that you could think of. Now, this was my way I wanted to build them. You should build yours the way that you want to build them. But I did the Unreal Roller as shiny, spanking new. I thought, you know, a steam roller doesn't have much of a chance to get dirty. A grader is always getting run rough. And even though these are complete fantasy vehicles and dragster type things, this is what I thought of them when I first saw them advertised by Atlantis a while ago. And they said these were going to be coming out. I said, okay, I want to do them both in one video, because I know the peeps would love to see two kits in one video, even though it's quite a bit of work. I want to do the grader as it's dusty and dirty and kind of rusted. And I want to do this Unreal Roller when I saw that corrugated roof and the big chrome wheels all the way around as a mint production. I had no idea that this was coming out in a metallic green. That worked even better with the rivet detail that I did in gold and the decals that are trimmed in gold. I just really like all that together. The only thing I really did different was that I chromed all the supports for the roof, because I like the chrome, and I did the steering wheel with the wood grain and then a chrome center. But the rest of it, you know, we did up. I got the black belt on there. We got the orange block. You can see on the Groovy Grader, I did a very light coat of that fire orange compared to a heavy coat of the fire orange. Looks like a new shiny engine. Looks like a dirty old engine. And then towards the end, I applied that oil wash on there that you saw in the part of the video to make it look like we got a lot of grease gathering dirt and all that stuff. Then on the lights, I did the tops in orange like they were markers and did the front with the Molotow chrome. Got the blade rusted and dirtied up and scraped up. So I had a beautiful time with these kits. Super easy to build. These could both be very first kits out of the box. You could get each one of them. One for you, one for the kids, the grandkids, the niece, the nephew, the daughter, the granddaughter, whatever you wanted, and build them up. The Groovy Grader is actually a heavy kit because of those rubber wheels, and they're fully articulated. So they move up and down as if it's going over terrain. You could build some cool fantasy outer world diorama. The decals go on both of them so nicely. That's why I wanted to show you slide on there. They're super thin yet strong, and they conform and they dry nice and quick, and they look lovely. So again, thanks to Model Roundup for sending these awesome kits. I see Atlantis has a lot more Tom Daniel kits, and I most certainly plan on building those, because the Tom Daniel kits, the fantasy kits by anyone, are just so much fun to do up and do your way. Thanks to Model Roundup. Thanks to Atlantis. Got that beautiful made in the USA. That's a very important thing, and we should strive for doing more of that. I want to thank you all for watching the show. And remember, always my points in every video. Build for you. It's your model kit. Remember, it's just a hobby. Take a breath and have fun. And we'll see all of you at the next review.